Okay, this is take two on this one. Hopefully the computer doesn't freeze up again. I'm finally getting around to answering the questions I have on from a friend on post-traumatic stress disorder. So let me get to those. Let's see. How do you know if post-traumatic stress is something you might have? And how do you talk to if you feel like no one believes you? Who do you talk to? Okay. I talk to my general practitioner. I go to a family practice doctor, and I talk to him, but I trust him now. It took us a long time to get to that point. And then if I need to go to a counselor, he'll send me to a counselor. And that's what I suggest. You find a doctor that you trust who can help you find a counselor. Let me see. And the way I found out that I had it is I was having panic attacks, and you've got to start paying attention. If you start feeling really uptight or like a caged animal is a good way to feel it, or if you have a regular panic attack where you feel short of breath, like you can't breathe, and I found that I have triggers. But you got to pay attention. And then once you can find those triggers, then you're able to identify what the problem is, and it helps a lot because then you can psychologically help yourself through it. You'll still feel the irrational emotions and they'll still be there, but now you'll know what it is. So if you're having irrational emotions and you don't know why and everything's fine and all of a sudden out of the blue it happens, you could have post-traumatic stress. If you know you've had things happen in your life that have traumatized you, you could have post-traumatic stress. But you will have to have periods where you're feeling really out of control, abnormal, and you don't know why. I mean, it could be other things, but this, I'm trying to describe it the best that I can. Mine came from I was molested by my grandfather and my cousin, and I've had abusive relationships over and over and over again. My mom was chronically ill all my life, and we took care of her. And then we took care of her when she was passing. So I've had constant stress for most of my life. Doctors told me if I do not get rid of stress in my life, I have no chance of getting better. And that was when I was in an abusive marriage, and I've got out of it since. Let me see. Do you talk to your doctor, or should you find a counselor to talk to? You need to have a doctor that you can trust, and then you trust their judgment, and so you can trust them to help you find a counselor. With some things with my post-traumatic stress, this is going to sound crazy, but I have found online help where I have went to Al-Anon, because some of my post-traumatic stress, I was able to control some things through Al-Anon. Because some things I can't control in life, and I had to accept that, and Al-Anon has helped me. It sounds crazy when you don't have a substance abuse problem, but Al-Anon has helped me a lot. Let's see. All right. I think that's the question she had. All the questions she had. I hope that helps you. Okay, the week when I was like going off on people for my pictures, that I'm not smiling enough in my pictures and stuff, I had a trigger then. Was that last week or was that the week before? I can't even remember stuff right now. Triggers can be a scent. It can be something someone says, and it doesn't have to have anything to do with the abuse or the person or anything. It can be some random thing. Like, seriously, you could have been around abuse and there could have been incense burning, a certain kind, and you never even knew it. You didn't notice it at the time, you don't notice it now, but when that scent comes up, all of a sudden, boom, your brain is right back there, and you're feeling out of control and uptight, and just, you can't relax. It's an anxious feeling. I don't usually have regular panic attacks anymore, but every once in a while I will. My friends now recognize if I'm having a panic attack, or you need to be able to at least identify so the people around you don't think that you're just going crazy, so you can explain to them. Like when you have PMS, you can explain to them the same thing. Say, I'm having a trigger from post-traumatic stress. I need some time because I need the time alone. I need to get away, you know, in my room or whatever, alone to wait till it passes and do what I need to do, which is an individual thing. But you've got to be able to recognize those triggers before you can help yourself is one thing that I have noticed. Because before, when I didn't recognize what it was, I couldn't do anything about it. So, sorry I'm so fidgety. I just feel like I look awful right now on camera. Oh, well. All right. Well, I hope that helps. I've got to go and babysit my granddaughter. I have been feeling flu-ish, so Daryl's coming over to help me. But the coffee has helped. I don't know. I don't understand, but for some reason, coffee has helped. All right, if you have more questions, write them to me so I can read them off and answer them. All right, peace. Have a great weekend.